Today we come together as brothers and sisters around this holy table to celebrate the good news in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the peace, the love, and the grace of God be always with you.
Amen.
As we gather today, let us close our eyes for a moment. And as we come and recognize that we're not perfect, as we recognize that we need God in our lives to be able to have a good relationship with Him and with other people, let us ask Him to forgive us our sins. Lord Jesus, you came that we might have life. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you speak wisdom. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you continually bring peace, reconciliation, and justice. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Now let us unite our voices and hearts to give praise and glory to our God, saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. As we gather today, we pray for healing, peace, justice, and understanding in our country, in our church, in our community. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that endure forever. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, ask something of me and I will give it to you. Solomon answered, O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king, to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours? The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you will come no one equal to you. The word of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
Lord, I love your commands.
Lord, I love your commands.
I have said, O Lord, that my part is to keep your words. The law of your mouth is more to me precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Lord, I love your commands.
Let your kindness comfort me, according to your promise to your servants. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight.
Lord, I love your commands.
For I love your commands more than gold, however fine. For in all your precepts I go forward, every false way I hate.
Lord, I love your commands.
Wonderful are your decrees, therefore I observe them. The revelation of your words sheds light, giving understanding to the simple.
Lord, I love your commands.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
According to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field that a person finds and hides again. Then out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today in the first reading we hear the example of somebody who wants to have a good and healthy relationship with somebody else. In the first reading we hear the story of King Solomon, or the beginning of the story of King Solomon, who was chosen by God to be the king of the Jewish people. And as King Solomon is preparing to be the king, God comes in a dream and asks him, ask for whatever you want, I'm going to give it to you. And King Solomon, who wants to have a good healthy relationship with the people that God has given us, asks for two very important things: wisdom and understanding. That's what King Solomon asked for. He could have asked for anything he wanted: riches, fame, cars, money, material things. He could have asked for anything he wanted, but he only asked for two things: wisdom and understanding heart. And the two things he asked were not for himself. The two things he asked was for other people, to have a better relationship with others. As some time ago, I was in a meeting with people who have participated in a movement we have in the church. It's called Retrovive. Retrovive, it's a 3-day retreat we have for couples who are going through difficult times, people who are at the end of the relationship, people who are thinking about divorce or separation already. And in many times, this retreat is the last chance that they have as a couple to build their relationship. And what we do during this weekend is we try to support them, and we try to share with them some ways in which they can communicate and talk better in their lives. And after they leave this this weekend, they gather weekly and then monthly as a group to talk about other communication tools and how they can increase their relationship with God and their people. So as I was in one of these meetings, and the question for the couples was, what's the biggest obstacle as you try to talk to, as you try to dialogue with your spouse, what's the biggest obstacle? And I was surprised that most of the couples in the meeting responded that the biggest or the hardest thing for them as they talk to their spouses and they try to talk to each other is the biggest, the most difficult thing is to try to put their own feelings and their own emotions aside to be able to listen and to understand their spouses. That's the biggest thing. The biggest thing for them is to try to put their desires, their emotions, their ego aside so that they can really listen to their spouse and understand what he or she is trying to say. And I think for most of us, it is true in most of our relationships. Just think about little children, brothers and sisters, when they are fighting for the same toy, or when they are fighting to have the same TV remote control, or now I guess they fight for the iPhone and they fight for the iPad. I mean, why do they fight? Because each one of them wants the same thing, and nobody wants to give up. They want to win. So the most difficult thing for them is to put aside their own ego, their own desires, their own emotions for the sake of somebody else. And that's a beautiful thing about Solomon. As he becomes the king of the Jewish people, he recognizes that he has to be very careful with his ego. He recognizes that these people that God has given him, it's very important. It's like a treasure. And he has been chosen by God to build a healthy relationship with him. So as he recognizes that his ego may be a problem building this healthy relationship with his people, he asks for two things. He asks for wisdom, and he asks for an understanding heart. And I think we as Christians, we have been also chosen by God, just like King David. We have been chosen by God to bring kindness, to bring justice, to be peace, to bring peace into our world, into our community, to our families. But for us to be able to truly build a healthy relationship, not only with God, but with other people, we have to put our own desires, we have to put our own emotions, we have to put our own ego aside to be able to have a heart that is understanding, a heart who can truly be in the place of the other person and not only listen to them, but to be able to understand and to be able to truly feel what the other person is trying to feel. Unfortunately, many times in our relationships with God and with other people, we let our emotions take the best of us. We let our feelings and our ego, what we want, what we desire, to lead the way of how we treat other people. That's not right. I was talking to a friend of mine who, unfortunately, in his work, he went through difficult times. He is part of the leadership team in his company, and he committed a mistake. I mean, he did something that he should have not done. And he was telling me the meeting he had with the other leadership people. It was, I think, five of them on the table, and every one of them, everybody, one of them was angry and upset and frustrated. And the only thing they were doing, they were insulting him, they were telling him how stupid he was, how bad he did his job, how he was ruining everything that they were working for. And he said, the only thing I could do was lower my head and just take whatever was coming my way. I mean, they never gave him the chance to explain, to apologize, to let them know what he was going through and feeling. Because these other people let just their emotions to cover them. How can we have a good relationship with somebody? How can we build a good relationship with somebody else and with God when our desires and our ego and what we want goes first? Today, Solomon was a very wise man. As God came to him and asked him, I can give you whatever you want, he asked for two things who were going to help him build a relationship with God and his people: wisdom and an understanding heart. A heart who is able to put aside his own desires, his own ego, for the sake of others, for the sake of the person who is in front of you. So as we gather today and as we come to this holy table to receive the body and the blood of Jesus, let us pray. Let us pray that God may give us the wisdom and understanding to be loving and merciful as he is with each one of us. So as we gather today, let us stand. And as we continue the good example of Solomon, let us profess the faith and love we have in God, saying, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before the ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered there and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Today we pray for God to give us wisdom and understanding, so today let us present to God all of our prayers and needs. That the whole church, each one of us, may continue building his kingdom through daily love and kindness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
That those who have died, especially Gail, as we celebrate the second anniversary of her passing, that God may give them eternal life in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
That all of us who struggle with understanding may pray to be as loving, as merciful as Jesus is with us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
That all grandparents, as we celebrate the feast of Jesus' grandparents, may continue to be blessed and protected by God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
That world leaders may have the same wisdom and understanding that Solomon requested, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that one day all Christians may come together to God's holy altar, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that all parents may have the wisdom of the Holy Spirit as they make important decisions for the schooling of their children next year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that God may give us the healing, peace, and justice we need in our country, our community, our families, and our church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
now I invite you to close your eyes for a moment, and in the silence of your hearts, present to God your own prayers. Wonderful God, give us an understanding heart to love you and each other and to be able to do your will in our lives. Today we place all of our prayers on your holy altar through the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima and Blessed Emily Gamelin, and in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away our iniquities and cleanse us from our sins. Now let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, accept the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just. It's our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and all the saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and the earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son Jesus, present here in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for his disciples and now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread and said a blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your dead, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and dead on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of eternal blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been entrusted to us, and grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Lord, bring your church to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Jesus and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to each one of us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, Blessed Emily Gamelin, Saint Joseph, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Now, as brothers and sisters who pray for wisdom and understanding to continue building the kingdom of God in Spokane, let us pray together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. Please remember to stay in your pews, and we're going to take communion to you. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the words of my
the body of Christ. Let us pray. O Lord, we have consumed this divine sacrament. Grant that this gift, which He Himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we ask God for His blessing, I talked to my mom during the week, and I guess she watched Mass last weekend or sometime this week, and she was curious why sometimes I'm here in the altar and then she sees me disappear back there. She was asking me what I do over there. So I say, Mom, there is no secret. It's the hand sanitizer is there, and that's where I have my mask. So I have to go over there and put it on and off and use hand sanitizer. But to her, that was the mystery, what's behind that wall. So I wish it was something better, but it's just hand sanitizer. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now let us go together to continue building God's kingdom with the wisdom and the understanding He has given us. Our Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for coming this evening. Have a wonderful week.
Amen.